So, Heidi. Good morning, good evening. Guys, that is the next episode from my series Back to Basics. My name is Gregor. I'm a German German player from Germany, and I try to explain the game, The Hunter Call of the Wild, in English as best as possible. I'm not a native Englishman, as I said before, so sometimes I have the problem to find the words. And I take for this one a dictionary. So if you have the situation that I don't find the correct word, I have to look at my dictionary. So, okay, timer is starting. In this episode, the fourth one, as far as I know, we're going to the shooting area. The shooting area is a free DLC you can obtain in your Steam store or Xbox store or PlayStation store. And before starting hunting in the game, I will train you how to exactly use the weapons, or this weapon, how to precisely aim and hit the target. I did this same exercise at my German beginners series. It is called Zurück auf Anfang. This means back to basics. It's the same word. And I did the same explanation to the German followers. For the German beginners, we do the same as here for you now. I like to say this game is about crouching, is about hunt, about lurking. It is about be stealthy to the animals, and we need to aim properly. Shooting, just making ping, boom. I can train 2 or 3 year old child. Aiming properly, I cannot train a 3 year old child. Aiming is something you need to know what to do, to know exactly what to do. And we will see that later at the shooting area. Sometimes at this road here, there are sometimes roe deers and fallow deers. At this moment not, that's great, funny. And when you know how to use the weapon exactly, it is more easy for you. It is more easy to you to hunt. If you don't know, if you just go to the forest, to the trees, to the plains, and you shoot without know how to aim, you have no success. You fail with your shooting, and you say, that game is crap, I don't hit anything. This game is not about shooting. If you want to play a shooter, play Counter-Strike or Fortnite or whatever, which is not popular to the younger man. If you want to hunt properly, you must aim properly. And if you aim properly, you can hit properly. And if you hit properly, the deer is dead. And that's we will try. At this moment we have a little problem because the fellow deer has now called. It's a warning call because our smell, our odor has been recognized by the deer. And the deer say, "Hey, Grigol, I know you are there. Don't come to me." And I said, "Of course, I try to come to the deer. But you see, the deer is running away. That's the fellow deer. And I will try to hunt it as well. I will mark the deer, and now I try to shoot it. It's whale. The way I hit it, because I know how to aim. Oh, nice, I tried. I forgot to load. I hit that one as well. And the third one is gone. I'm sorry. At this point, I must say, I miss the skills and the perks I have with my main account. Because the deers, which was been visible at the scope here, with my main account, I don't need to switch to the binoculars and mark the animals and switch back to my gun. I can mark the animals while looking through the scope. And I can recognize with my skills in the main account how far away they are. And if I know how far away the animals are, I can better place the shot. That I hit here two deers of three was pure luck. And skill, of course. I would say those which are not trained, those players. Oh, they're coming back. Uh-huh. Those which are not trained as me could easily miss the deers. The first one you see here is 100% okay. The next one, which is now to the right of it, it's hurt because you can see it. I can see it. You can't, but I can. Because of the position of the head. Because of the... It is not really healthy at the moment. The third one was also hurt. This one. The stay it stands there is not healthy. So I hope the animals will die. You see when you look at the head, the tongue is out. The mouth is open, the tongue is out. That's a big signal for the animal is hurt. It's a level 4. That's great. It's a big antlers. And with level 60 I have a skill to see about the health status of the animal. It is nearly dead. Is it maybe half dead or something like that. With this beginner account, of course, I don't have. The next animal here, the same problem. It is shot by me, but I have no idea if it is nearly dead or not. If I would know it, I can. I don't need to shoot. If I can see, okay, it's nearly dead. I don't need to shoot on it. But this two, I have no idea if they are dead or not, or nearly dead or not. So, I must shoot them. And I try to get a safe shot. This one from the side is a safe shot. When you sit and hit, no, sorry, when you hit the deer from the side into the lung, it's a safe shot. To place a shot with this scope here to the heart which would be great. It's nearly impossible. So if you hunt like this one from the side, that is normally a big wound, and now you see the deer is dead. This shot from behind wasn't good. Absolutely not. So, if possible, always look for the deer to show you the broadside, the left or the right side, so you can hit the deer in the lung, in the stomach. If you have the deer from the front, it's easy to hit a bone instead of the lung, instead of any softer parts of the body. Same problem from behind. The deer from the side is big. From the front or from the back, it is small. Small targets are harder to hit, and it's more likely that you miss the shot. From the right or left side, the target is big in your scope. So safe shots from the side, unsafe shots like this one. When I shoot this one in the front, I could barely miss. I could maybe hit the antlers, for example. I could hit the whatever, but not the best parts of the animal. So, I don't like to shoot them here, from this side. I wait. I have time. I have patience. As I said before, in the, I think, third or second episode, the best skill, the most important skill of a player is patience. If you have the patience to wait till the animal shows you the best side to shoot, then you are a good player. If you don't have patience and has no chance or no will, no will is not so bad. That's the point where I need my dictionary. The German word is Wille, and is something different to the English word will. The willingness is the English word. The willingness to wait. To wait for the right place, the right time to shoot. If you don't have the willingness, the patience to have the willingness, you will often shoot next to the deer. You hurt the deer, but you did not kill the deer. From this position, I don't like to shoot. They are unsafe. If I have better scope and better aiming experience that you, the new players, don't have at this point. If I had better experience, jeez, fuck. Not good. I hope the deer stopped showing the broadside, but it turns at 180 degrees. Sometimes I shoot, even I shoot crap. So the wind is not good for me, really not good. It's not really windy, but the wind is always there. And I cannot get really closer to it. The animals would smell me, and they will maybe not come back. So, I will stay here. I hope, and hope, and hope. This episode was about to go to the shooting range, and not to shoot on animals. I love it when the plan works. Yeah. And with my penetration ammunition I like to have, I could better penetrate the bodies of the animals. And I think I could kill them instantly. But with this crap ammunition here, the soft point bullet with more expansion than penetration, it is really hard to kill the animal. And I'm afraid that these two fellow deers will not come back. Because at this moment they are not coming back. What time says? 14 minutes left. Okie dokie, guys. We will go to harvest. Oh, what's that? There is another fellow deer. There are some other deers here inside the grass. We'll have a look here back to the place where the three guys were. No, nothing. Okie dokie. Oh, I forgot. I have a skill point. Skills. This one, the track knowledge, is a very important skill. I will explain it in the skill tree later in a special episode. Just for information, that for the stalker tree is the most important skill. For the ambusher, the same place, the spotting knowledge and the side spotting. That is the one I just mentioned a few minutes ago, the side spotting. Unlocks the ability to spot animals while in aim mode with weapons. This means that you do not have to switch to binoculars or rangefinder device to spot an animal. Unlocking this means I can watch through my scope and mark the animal, which I can't at the moment. And I'm missing that so much. Okay, guys, seems the two fellow deers are not coming back, and we have to search them. This one here on the left side, we will search later. You will see there's a red dot here, and that is here for shooting and killing animals. It does not mean that the animals are inside this dot. Only the first wound, the first hit, is in that area. In the worst case, you hit a deer, it is bleeding, maybe you shot it in the foot, in the leg, and it's humbling around the whole map. It can be die here at this point. But the red dot will be here, because the hit was at that place. And in this area, the track is starting. You can follow it, from footstep to footstep, from bloodprint to bloodprint, to the dead body. It does not mean that the dead body is inside this place. Hopefully, it is. If you aim properly, if you shoot properly, if you hit properly, it will be in that red dot. If not, if you're not aiming properly, if you're not hitting properly, if you're not shooting properly, you will have to make a long walk to find the deer. And at this state of the game, we need every deer we can get. So if you only shoot and do not search, do not find the animals, you don't get the credits, you don't get the XP, you don't get the weapon points, the ammunition points, or whatever you need. Confirm trophy, so it's leave no animal behind. I don't know what it is, but that's a fellow deer, not a good one, because we had, well, I'm first shot was flash and second one flash and left lung. That is a safe shot. The first shot was from behind, and you can see this silhouette is small. It's an unsafe shot. This one is a bigger silhouette. This from the side is a safe shot. This is a safe shot. A shot to the lung. With the lung, normally any animals are 99% dead. That is the shot you must take. Please forget headshots, brain shots, or something like that. It's very popular in shooting games to make headshots. Forget it. You in hunting game, in hunting simulation, shoot to the lungs and you will get success. I'm sorry for the rain, but I cannot stop it. The weather you cannot control. So let's have a look for the other animals. Oh yeah, the 2-4C polymer tip bullets are now available. Thank goodness. So let's have a find. Maybe we find the other animals. There must be somewhere. They're always... that's the old blood prints. Hang on. I hear something. It's not only the rain. I think there is an animal stuck in the tree. It sounds like a stuck, like a stuck animal. Is it? There is it. Yeah. Sometimes the animals are buggy. old, the old-fashioned way is hunting without any scope. Confirmed trophy. So the first shot was from behind to the back. Bad shot. The dead shot. Flash to the lung. So, as I said before, shoot to the lung. So, there should be maybe one more. But I have no clue. This is the only, this is the one where I shot only once. And I have no idea if that deer is dead or not. I don't think so. Because I have no idea where to find the dead deer. Is there? Nope. Just this. So we will try to track down the deer. To look the footprints, the blood prints. The blood rate is very low. That is a sign for a small wound. And sometimes these wounds get can be closed. So you will don't you will not find any blood prints anymore. And I'm afraid at this point. At this one we will stop here. I will go back to my outpost and I must change the ammunition. I cannot work with this bloody crap. Sorry. Rain, rain, rain. Yeah? Will it stop? Will it stop? Will it stop? Rain, stop. Okay. Sometimes rain, listen to me. So, rifle ammo, I want to have this one. And I buy it now. 40 rounds. And suck. I take it from the storage to my inventory and take the old one. This crap. What? I don't want to have. So. And I change the ammunition here. Great. Rain starts again. Good. 2 minutes and 25 seconds left on the clock. So. It's time to stop this episode now. And we will see us in the next episode. And then I try. No. We do now. We go now to the shooting area, but we do not shoot. We just take the quad, the vehicle. And it's loud. Oh, sorry. So I go now with the quad to the shooting range. So we can start the next episode from that place. And we do not stop to any animals. With the C button, if you with the C button for Charlie, you can switch the sights from third person view to first person view. You can move the camera if you want. Sometimes you are able to make stunts when you are able to hit one. Oh, okay, this one is not working. Sometimes it's only fun. Right here. So, there's the shooting area. I have to unlock it, and then episodes ends. So, you see a storage container to the left, where you can also buy all weapons you need. And the bloody rain annoys me again. So, episode is over. We will see us in the next episode when we shoot at the shooting range. I wish you a good day, a good evening, good hunting in the game, and see you next time. Bye bye.